Welcome students, today we are going to know about PHP with MySQL database. In this chapter, we can know how to access your MySQL database with the use of PHP script and how we work on the architecture of the web application and how to query a database, session control and cookie controls in PHP and what are the functionality of the session and how to implement a simple session and configuring the session and implementing the authentication with the session control and interacting with the files, that is file system and the server, how to interact using the PHP script and uploading the files either in the images or the HTML files and writing the PHP script to deal with the file. And last is the error handling. Then first we have to know about web application architecture. This architecture mainly having the concept of interactions between the applications, middleware systems and the databases, which is to ensure the multiple applications can work together. So with these web applications like the PHP, Python, Java and the middleware systems, it is used in the software, which is the term used to enable the communication and management of data in the distributed applications, which is work on transport layer of TCP/IP layers. With this concept, that we must have two programs running concurrently, the code which lies in the browser and responds to user input. This means we are giving the input by the HTML forms. The code will react according to the PHP script and display the output in the browser. The code which lives on the server in response to the HTTP request. That is, we already know about the HTTP Hypertext Transfer Protocol, which responds to the request coming from the client side. So this is the two programs running concurrently, both the request from the user and response from the server side. Then this is the web architecture works. It is works on the T-tier architecture, which means the presentation layer, application layer and persistence layer. For presentation layer, we are having the browsers and the desktop for displaying our output. And next one is application layer. We are using the PHP script for request and response from the server. And next you are having the database MySQL for management of data, that is accessing the database using your PHP script. So this works on the T-tier architecture. One is displaying, that is presentation layer, on PHP scripting codes in the application layer, and persistence layer, this is the database server. This figure clearly shows the PHP mainly concentrate on the file system and the databases. The file system interaction and database interaction plays the main role in the PHP scripting codes. And the web server architecture also shows where is the web server placed in between the databases and the client. The client must request and response from the request server and response is get from the web server. This is the example of how to input the from the user is by the HTML and the particular query to be executed and displays in the browser. So first you have the author Michael Morgan is the input and it search for the particular author name in the book table, and if it is live it displays the output, if it fails it results the error result. So first web server receives the request from the HTML form and it passes to the PHP engine, and the PHP engine thereby execute the query, and there the PHP opens the connection and execute the query. Then it will process it and send the result to the PHP engine, and finally the PHP engine displays the query in the browser. Here you can see the program here.